Woody plants are usually easy to recognize. If you think a tree or shrub is woody, you are probably right. Only a few plants will fool you. Palms and bamboos have no wood. Most woody plants add a new layer of wood called a growth ring around their trunk, branches, and roots every year. There is no theoretical limit to how long a plant can live or how wide it can become. In this photo, 6th grade children line up in front of a Montezuma cypress in Mexico known as the El Arbol del Tule. The trunk, 119 feet in circumference and roughly 38 feet in diameter, supports a crown the size of almost 2 tennis courts. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and in this video, I'll discuss the structure of woody plants. In herbs, only the primary plant body develops. In woody species, additional tissues are produced in the stem and root from other meristems, the vascular cambium and the cork cambium, producing the wood and bark. They constitute the plant's secondary body. Woody plants are a combination of primary and secondary tissue. An herb's conducting capacity is set after a portion of stem or root is mature, while woody plants become wider by accumulation of wood and bark, giving them greater conducting capacity. There are disadvantages to secondary growth. They have a greater need for defenses, both structural and chemical. They must use energy and nutrient resources for winterizing their bodies in temperate climates. And it's expensive metabolically to construct wood and bark. The energy expended on these activities is not being used for reproduction. Therefore, woody plants may not reproduce until they're several years old. True secondary growth occurs in many eudicots, most basal angiosperms, and all gymnosperms, but not in ferns or monocots. As part of the secondary plant body, woody plants form a ring called the vascular cambium as they mature, extending it each year. They are rarely found in leaves, but never in flowers, fruits, or seeds. Two types of cells make up the vascular cambium: fusiform cells and ray initials. Fusiform cells are long tapered cells. They divide longitudinally and produce 2 elongate cells. One continues to form the fusiform initial, the other differentiates into a cell of secondary xylem or secondary phloem. Secondary xylem cells increase greatly in diameter, causing the cambial cells to be pushed outward. Ray initials are similar to fusiform initials, but are short and cuboidal. They divide and develop similarly, but form xylem or phloem parenchyma that function in storage or albuminous cells in gymnosperms. All cells formed on the inside of the vascular cambium develops into secondary xylem, known as wood. Wood contains tracheids, vessel elements, fibers, sclerids, and parenchyma. The arrangement of the secondary xylem cells reflects that the fusiform and ray initials in an axial or radial system, respectively. An axial system is derived from the fusiform initials and contains tracheary elements to carry out vertical conduction of water through the wood. There are fibers in the axial system of wood angiosperms. Hardwoods contain large amounts of fibers, while softwoods contain few or none. Axial xylem parenchyma is a temporary reservoir of water. Most gymnosperms contain only tracheids in their axial systems, and fibers and parenchyma cells are sparse or absent. In woody angiosperms, the radial system contains only parenchyma, arranged as masses called rays. Ray parenchyma cells store carbohydrates and other nutrients and conduct material over short distance radially. In gymnosperms, xylem rays often contain resin canals. Growth rings appear due to the differential growth of the early spring wood versus the late summer wood. In the springtime, the new expanding leaves are thin and delicate. Leaves like this lose water at a rapid rate, and thus trees need a high capacity for conduction at this time. Spring wood has a high proportion of wide vessels or tracheids, while summer wood has fewer vessels or narrow, thick-walled tracheids. In the summer, the cuticle is thickened, transpiration is less, and large numbers of newly formed vessels are conducting rapidly. There's no growth in winter. Together, early wood and late wood make up an annual growth ring. Wood with vessels found mostly in early wood is called ring porous. Wood with vessels found throughout is diffuse porous, such as yellow birch, aspen, sugar maple, and American holly. In conifers, wood has only tracheids in its axial system, but it still has early wood. The center of a log, the heartwood, is almost always darker, drier, and more frequent than the outer wood, the sapwood. Tracheary elements of heartwood no longer function in water transport and are sealed off to prevent spread of disease. A tylosis forms a plug from adjacent parenchyma cells. The wood parenchyma cells produce compounds that inhibit growth of bacteria and fungi. This makes heartwood dark and aromatic. Once all parenchyma cells in the area die, decay-resistant heartwood has formed. In branches or trunks that are not vertical, gravity causes a lateral stress. If not counteracted, the branch would droop. Reaction wood is produced in response to lateral stress. In angiosperms, this develops mostly on the upper side of the branch. It is known as tension wood. Tension wood contains gelatinous fibers enriched with cellulose. Conifers form reaction wood enriched with lignin on the underside of the branch. This is known as compression wood. Because the secondary phloem is formed from the vascular cambium just as secondary xylem is, it too has an axial and radial system. The axial system is responsible for conduction up and down the stem and root. It contains sieve elements. Fibers and non-conducting parenchyma are usually present. Phloem rays are formed just as xylem rays. They consist of parenchyma storage cells. Sieve elements usually conduct for less than 1 year. Only the innermost layer of phloem is capable of conduction. Carbohydrate accumulates in the barks of stems and roots during the early summer while leaves are still present and photosynthesizing. It reaches its peak in September and October and then drops and remains steady throughout the winter. It is released during the spring growth season, April and May. As secondary tissues are added and pushed outward, tissues on the periphery either grow in circumference or are torn apart. As circumferential stretching increases and older sieve elements die, some storage parenchyma cells undergo cell division. This results in a new cambium within secondary phloem, the cork cambium. After each division, the inner cell remains cork cambium while the outer cell differentiates into a cork cell. In a few species, the cork cambium may produce a cell or two to the inside that mature into a layer of parenchyma called the phelloderm. The layers of cork cells and the phelloderm, if any, are known as periderm. Cork cells become encrusted with suberum and die. This makes them waterproof and chemically inert. All plant material exterior to the periderm dies for lack of water and nutrients. The layer of cork cells cannot expand much circumferentially. A new cork cambium forms in younger secondary phloem closer to the vascular cambium. All tissues outside the innermost cork cambium comprises the outer bark. All secondary phloem between the vascular cambium and the innermost cork cambium is the inner bark. The first cork cambium may arise in a number of tissues, epidermis, cortex, primary phloem, or secondary phloem. Subsequent cork cambia form afterward, deep in the secondary phloem. The first bark on young stems may differ from the bark it adds as it ages. This is due to the origin of the first cork cambium. It may arise in different tissues from the later cork cambium. The impermeability of cork has negative as well as advantageous consequences. Although it keeps out pathogens and retains water, it also blocks the absorption of oxygen, interfering with the respiration of the sapwood, vascular cambium, and inner bark. The bark becomes permeable to oxygen when rounded cork cells are produced. The round shape prevents the tight packing of the cells. This creates more intercellular space. These regions of parenchymous cork are lenticels. When a new cork cambium arises interior to this one, it forms a lenticel in the same place. The outer and inner lenticels are aligned. Roots of conifers and woody angiosperms undergo secondary growth as do the stems. Bark also forms in perennial roots. Vascular cambium arises when parenchyma cells between the primary xylem and phloem become mitotically active. Pericycle cells near the protoxylem are also activated where the first cork cambium usually arises. This causes the endodermis, cortex, and epidermis to be shed. Lenticels also occur that are especially prominent near lateral roots. Secondary growth occurs in roots much like it does in stems. We can see the growth of woody tissue in these younger roots, where you can just see the vascular cambium to these older roots, and the axial system and set of rays. Wood may be dissimilar when the conductivity requirements of roots and stems differ. Storage capacity is often increased in woody roots. The rays become much larger, increasing in the number of storage ray parenchyma. Axial parenchyma in the wood can also be used as storage. In many storage roots, wood is almost pure parenchyma. The part of carrot or radish we eat is the wood of the storage root. It doesn't look like wood because it's mostly parenchyma with a few vessels and no fibers. When we peel the carrot, we remove a thin bark and all secondary phloem. There are alternative types of cambium structure and activity. Because they produce different secondary bodies, it's called anomalous secondary growth. In the roots of sweet potatoes, the storage parenchyma is increased as cambia are produced in groups of vessels. These cambia produce xylem and phloem as almost all parenchyma. In some monocots, such as this Joshua tree, an anomalous secondary growth occurs. A type of vascular cambium arises outside the outermost vascular bundles in the cortex. Only parenchyma cells are produced. Columns of some parenchyma cells produce narrow cells that differentiate into a secondary vascular bundles. Fibers occur exterior to these bundles that give these trees a woody character and allow branching. The trunk of a palm tree does not taper or branch. It seems woody because the vascular bundles are enclosed in a sheath of fibers. During the seedling years, palms produce adventitious roots from the base of the short stem. Each root adds extra vascular bundles. This is establishment growth, a form of primary growth. This type of growth also occurs in other monocots with extremely broad stems, such as corms and bulbs. In conclusion, secondary growth differs from primary growth by increasing the girth of the plant and allowing it to conduct more water and nutrients. It is formed by vascular or cork cambium producing wood or bark of trees and roots.